Hello friends, welcome you in the YouTube channel Yashwath in Competitive Mathematics. In this video, we shall see the fully solved question paper for the practical examination of SYBSc Mathematics of 2018. Now let us see the paper pattern for the practical examination in mathematics. There is a first question on multivariable calculus which contains 16 marks. In that, part A is attempt any one out of the two questions for 8 marks and B attempt any two questions out of the three given questions for 8 marks. In second question, there are two subsections, section A and section B. Section A, discrete mathematics for 16 marks. Again, same pattern, any one out of two and attempt any two out of three. Section B, Laplace transform and Fourier series for 16 marks. A is attempt any one out of the two and B is attempt any two out of the three for 8 marks each. Student have first question compulsory and from second A and second B have to solve any one question. This is the first page of the question paper of October 2018. Instructions are given. Question number one is compulsory. Attempt any one out of the questions 2a and 2b. Use of non-programmable calculator is allowed. Figures to the right indicate full marks and 32 marks are given for written examination and 8 marks are for oral examination. Dear friend, if you are not subscribed to the channel yet, please subscribe the channel Yashwath in Competitive Mathematics and press bell icon for getting updates from this channel. Also, press like button if you like this video and don't forget to share this video with your friends so that many students can watch this video and get benefit. Question first A. Attempt any one of the following for 8 marks. Discuss the differentiability of the function fxy equal to x square plus y square sine of 1 by root of x square plus y square when xy not equal to 0, 0 and equal to 0 when xy equal to 0. Solution of this. Friend, we need fx and fy for the differentiability. Fx 0, 0 equal to limit h tends to 0, h square sine 1 by h minus 0 divided by h, which is equal to limit h tends to 0, h sine 1 by h, that is 0. And fy 0, 0 equal to limit k tends to 0, k square sine 1 by k minus 0 divided by k, which is limit k tends to 0, k sine 1 by k, again it is 0. Thus we get fx 0 0 equal to 0 and fy 0 0 equal to 0. Now for differentiability we have to calculate f of del x del y minus f of 0 0, which is nothing but del x square plus del y square sine of 1 upon del x square plus del y square minus 0 f of 0 0, which can be written as 0 into del x plus 0 into del y plus del x into del x sine of del x square plus del y square plus del y into del y sine of 1 upon del x square plus del y square. This can be expressed as fx 0 0 del x plus fy 0 0 del y plus del x epsilon 1 plus del y epsilon 2, where epsilon equal to del x sine of 1 upon del x square plus del y square, which tends to 0, and epsilon 2 equal to del y sine of 1 upon del x square plus del y square, which again tends to 0 as del x del y tends to 0 0. And therefore, f of xy is differentiable at 0 0. Question second. Show that the greatest value of 10xyz under the condition x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 equal to 1 is 80 by root 3. Here we have to use method of undetermined multipliers. For that, suppose fxyz equal to 10xyz and g of xyz equal to given condition x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 minus 1 equal to 0. Its auxiliary function is capital F equal to f of xyz plus lambda times g of xyz. Therefore, f equal to 10xyz plus lambda into x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 minus 1 equal to 0. For solving, we shall differentiate this function f with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z, and with respect to lambda. And we get fx equal to 10yz plus 2 lambda x by 9 equal to 0. Fy equal to 10xz plus 2 lambda y by 16 equal to 0. Fz equal to 10xy plus 2 lambda z by 4 equal to 0. And f lambda equal to x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 minus 1 equal to 0. Multiplying this equation number 1 by x, equation 2 by y, 3 by z, we get 10xyz plus 2 lambda x square by 9 equal to 0. Equation 5, 10xyz plus 2 lambda y square by 16 equal to 0. Equation 6, 10xyz plus 2 lambda z square by 4 equal to 0. Equation 7, adding these equations, we get 30xyz plus 2 lambda times x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 equal to 0. From condition, it is given that x square by 9 plus y square by 16 plus z square by 4 equal to 1. Therefore, we get 2 lambda plus 30xyz equal to 0. And hence, lambda equal to minus 15xyz. From equation 8 and 5, we can calculate 10xyz plus 2 times minus 15xyz x square divided by 9 equal to 0. And therefore, x square can be obtained as 3, and hence x equal to root 3. In similar fashion, from 8 and 6 and from 8 and 7, we can calculate y equal to 4 by root 3, z equal to 2 by root 3. Therefore, the point root 3, 4 root 3, 2 root 3 is a stationary point. We should substitute this value in the 10xyz and obtain maximum value of the function, which is 10 into root 3 into 4 by root 3 into 2 by root 3 equal to 80 by root 3. Question B. Attempt any two of the following for 8 marks, that means 4 marks for each subsection. Let f of xyz equal to tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z and epsilon equal to 0.03. Show that there exists a delta greater than 0 such that for all xyz, root of x square plus y square plus z square less than delta implies f of xyz minus f of 0,0,0 is less than epsilon. F of xyz equal to tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z and epsilon equal to 0.03. F of xyz minus f of 0,0,0, this is less than or equal to tan square x plus tan square y plus tan square z. Now if mod of x is less than delta, mod of y is less than delta, mod of z is less than delta, then f of xyz minus f of 0,0,0 is less than 3 delta square is equal to epsilon. Therefore, there exists tan square delta is equal to epsilon by 3, which is 0.03 by 3 equal to 0.01. And hence tan delta is equal to 0.1. Hence delta equal to tan inverse 0.1. Second sub-question. If w x equal to xy and x equal to cos of t, y equal to sin of t, then find dw by dt at t equal to pi by 2. We use chain rule here. Dw by dt equal to dw by dx into dx by dt plus dw by dy into dy by dt is equal to y into minus sin of t plus x into cos of t. Therefore, dw by dt equal to substituting value of x and y, we get minus sin square t plus cos square t. And hence, dw by dt at t equal to pi by 2 equal to minus sin square pi by 2 plus cos square pi by 2, which is minus 1 plus 0 equal to minus 1. Third, change the order of integration and hence evaluate integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to root of 1 minus x squared dy dx divided by 1 plus e raised to y into root of 1 minus x squared minus y squared. Answer. Changing the order of integration, the limit 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 and 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 1 minus x square changes to 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 1 and 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to root of 1 minus y square. Therefore, given integral 0 to 1, integration 0 to root of 1 minus x square dy dx dy dx divided by 1 plus e raised to y into root of 1 minus x minus y square becomes integral 0 to 1 integral 0 to root of 1 minus y square dx dy divided by 1 plus e raised to y into root of 1 minus x square minus y square, which is equal to integral 0 to 1 1 by 1 plus e raised to y into sine of x by root of 1 minus y square from 0 to root of 1 minus y square dy, which is integral 0 to 1 1 by 1 plus e raised to y into pi by 2 minus 0 dy. Taking pi by 2 out of integration, we get pi by 2 integral 0 to 1 1 by 1 plus e raised to y dy. Put 1 plus e raised to y equal to t, therefore dy equal to dt by t minus 1, and hence we get integral pi by 2 times integral 0 to 1 plus e of 1 by t into 1 by t minus 1 dt equal to pi by 2 integral 2 to 1 plus e 1 upon t minus 1 minus 1 upon t dt equal to pi by 2 log of t minus 1 by t from 2 to 1 plus e, which is pi by 2 log of e by 1 plus e minus log of 1 by 2. That is nothing but pi by 2 times log of 2e divided by 1 plus e. Second, A is on discrete mathematics. Attempt any one of the following. Show that P implies Q or P implies R and P implies Q or R are logically equivalent. For this, we shall prepare a truth table for the columns P implies Q or P implies R. And second, P implies Q or R. If truth values in both the columns are equal or identical, then the two statements are equivalent. Here in column 7 and column 8, we see that the truth values are identical and hence both the statements are equivalent. Question 2. In how many ways can a photographer at a wedding arrange 6 people in a row, including a bride and groom, if the bride must be next to the groom, the bride is not next to groom, the bride is positional somewhere to the left of the groom? Solution. For first, the bride must be next to the groom. We have ways 2 factorial into 5 factorial, that is 240. For second, bride is not next to groom, that means we have to subtract this from total number of ways, that is 6 factorial minus 240, which is 720 minus 240 equal to 480. And the bride is positioned somewhere, that means 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 into 4 factorial, that is 15 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that is 360. B. Attempt any two of the following. Let QXY be the statement X has sent an email message to Y where the domain of both X and Y consists of all students in your class. Express the following quantifications in English. First, there exists X, there exists Y. QXY can be explained as some students has sent an email message to some students in your class. Second, there exists y for all y, qxy can be expressed as some student has sent an email message to all students in your class. Third, for all x, there exists y, qxy can be expressed as all students was sent an email message to some students in your class. And fourth, there exists y for all x, qxy can be expressed as there is a student who receive an email message from all students in your class. Second, using direct proof, prove that if m plus n and m plus n plus p are even integers, where m and n, m, n and p are integers, then m plus p is also even. Solution. Let m plus n and n plus p be the even integers. Therefore, m plus n can be written as 2k1, n plus p can be written as 2k2. Therefore, m plus n plus n plus p equal to 2k1 plus 2k2, and therefore m plus p equal to 2k1 plus 2k2 minus 2n, which is equal to 2 into k1 plus k2 minus n. This shows that m plus p is even integer. Question 3. How many positive integers not exceeding 1000 are divisible by 7 or 11? Let a be the event that 1000 is divisible by 7 and b be the event that 1000 is divisible by 11. Therefore, number of elements mod a equal to 1000 by 7 equal to 142. Mod b equal to number of elements in b equal to 1000 divided by 11 equal to 90. And a intersection b, that means number divisible by both a and b, 7 and 11, equal to 1000 divided by 7 into 11. It is approximately 12. And therefore, by inclusion exclusion principle, mod of a union b equal to mod of a plus mod of b minus mod of a intersection b, which is 142 plus 90 minus 12 equal to 220. And so, number of integers divided by 7 or 11 are 220. Question second B, Laplace transform and Fourier series. A, attempt any one of the following for 8 marks. A function fx is defined on the interval minus pi to pi as fx equal to pi plus x when x lies between minus pi to 0 and pi minus x when x lies between 0 to pi. Obtain the Fourier series expansion for fx. Solution. Fx equal to Fourier series expansion is fx equal to a naught by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx. Fx is an even function, therefore bn equal to 0 for all n equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. And a naught equal to 1 by pi integral 0 to 2 pi fx dx equal to pi. An equal to 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi fx cos nx equal to 0 if n is even equal to 4 by n square pi if n is odd. This is bn, a naught and an. A naught is pi and an is 0 or 4 by n square plus pi. Therefore, fx equal to pi by 2 plus 4 by pi sigma n from 1 to infinity n is odd 1 upon n square cos nx. Find L inverse of 1 upon s into s square plus 25 by using convolution theorem. L inverse of 1 upon s equal to 1, which is f of t. L inverse of 1 upon s square plus 25 equal to sin phi t by phi equal to gt. Therefore, L inverse of 1 upon s into s square plus 25 equal to integral 0 to t f of t minus u gu du equal to integral 0 to t 1 into sin phi u by phi u du equal to 1 by 5 integral 0 to t sin phi u du equal to minus cos phi u by 25 0 to t equal to minus cos phi u t by 25 plus 1 by 25. B, attempt any two of the following. Evaluate integral 0 to t e raised to minus 2 t sin 3 t by t dt. L of sin 3 t equal to 3 by s square plus 9. L of sin 3 t by t equal to integral s to infinity 3 by s square plus 9 ds equal to tan inverse s by 3 from s to infinity, which is pi by 2 minus tan inverse s by 3. And hence integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st sin 3 t by t dt equal to pi by 2 minus tan inverse s by 3. Second, evaluate L inverse 2s plus 3 divided by s square plus 4s plus 9. L inverse of 2s plus 3 divided by s square plus 4s plus 9 equal to L inverse of 2 times 2s plus 2 times s plus 2 minus 1 divided by s plus 2 square plus 5 equal to e raised to minus 2t L inverse of 2s minus 1 divided by s square plus 5 equal to e raised to minus 2t L inverse of 2 times s upon s square plus 5 minus 1 upon s square plus 5 equal to e raised to minus 2t 2 times cos of root 5 t minus 1 by root 3 times sin of root 5 t. Solve dy by dt plus y equal to 1 when y 0 equal to 2 easy by using Laplace transform. S ly minus y 0 plus ly equal to 1 by s. Therefore, Ly equal to 1 by s plus s 1 by s plus 1. And hence, y equal to, applying L inverse to both sides, L inverse of 1 by s plus L inverse of 1 by s plus 1, which is 1 plus e raised to minus t. Thank you.